Here, Cousin Britt from Massachusetts.
Yeah.
Who's further than Massachusetts? Thanks, Cousin Britt. Love you. Thank you for all coming to celebrate this special day. As I look around, I realize how many friends Alex and Kimberly have. And I hope that you all have a wonderful evening. Special thanks to those who made this event possible. My beautiful, wonderful wife, Paula. Exceptional praise for being such a wonderful mom, raising a wonderful daughter, and putting up with her fishing husband. She made a rut to the mall and back the last 3 months, the kettle rut, and she made list after list after list after list after list. Thank you, honey, for all your work. Kimberly, thank you, honey. You're organized, you're precise, you're articulate. And there's a rut between Kenmore and Tacoma. All the bridesmaids, Alicia, Marisa, Alyssa and Rachel, thank you all very much. And the groomsmen, Ross, Ryan, Justin, and Ben. I know you guys didn't do very much. Thanks for keeping Alex. Thanks for keeping Alex, for the most part, out of trouble. And I just want to say that this evening would not be possible without a young lady sitting over there, Candace McLeod. She told me not to embarrass her, but special thanks to Candace, because without her, Paul and I would have never gotten together, and if that wouldn't have happened, Kimberly would have never happened, and this would have never happened. So thank you very much, and goodbye. There's way more to that story, but we love you, Candy. Thank you. So I'm supposed to talk about Kimberly now, but I'm going to switch that around and start with Alex. So this is what I've come to know and love. So, Kimberly comes home and tells me she spotted this Alex at the Redmond Athletic Club. Now, there's a theme there. My wife and I's first date was at the Redmond Athletic Club. Kimberly grew up in the Redmond Athletic Club, and she finds her husband at the Redmond Athletic Club. I thought that was kind of ironic. So, into my house walks this hunky, studly, 6'3", half-tie dude, and he made Kimberly smile. And you know what? My mom immediately fell in love with him as a stalker ever since. Love you, Mom. She knows a good thing when she sees it. Yeah. So not only is he a studly and handsome, he can cook a mean Thai lob, amongst other things. He can play a mean game of basketball, and right away I was dreaming of superstar grandkids. So I've come to appreciate Alex as steady, calm, hardworking, smart, problem solver, and most important, patient. A perfect match for my sometimes opinionated, sometimes hard-headed, and sometimes emotional but wonderful daughter. Thank you in advance for taking great care of my daughter. Appreciate it, Alex. Love you, man. So I've been married 30 years to the same woman, and I sort of got to go have a recipe of success. I do my best. So these are words of wisdom to Mr. Alex as we move forward. One, memorize this. Kimberly, I'm sorry. Number two, Kimberly, please forgive me. Number three, Kimberly, I was wrong. And the most important two words in the language of a man is, Kimberly, yes, dear. So with that, Mr. Alex Carter, I welcome you to the family. And so far, so good. So, to my dearest Kimberly. I knew this would happen, so I wrote a poem for my daughter. My dearest Kimberly, oh, how I love you so. You are my one and only daughter, a true miracle from the very get-go. Mom's tubes were a mess until the doctors cleared them of their stuff. The doctor said, now's the time, son. I could not get home fast enough. Nine months later, you entered our lives, and oh, what a thrill. For hours, we gaze at you, our sweet little girl. You were a mighty challenge those first 4 years, bringing many times bringing your mom and I.